So are you stuck on how to quickly organize your computer files and how to keep them organized? Watch this video for my top three tips. I'm Jane Solar and I'm a life biz organizer. I'm so glad that you landed on this channel. For the best organizing advice and hopefully inspirational tips, please hit the bell to be notified when I post a new video every week. If you're dreaming of having a more productive digital organization system or filing system on your computer, keep watching. Your system needs to be quick and sustainable. And at the end of this chapter, I'll be giving you my number one productivity tool. And all you have to do is enter your email for a chance to win it. So my first tip is to create a system. As with most of my advice, it starts with planning. And a system is usually my first step in anything that goes with digital files too. You might be thinking, well, it's too late as I already have too many files and I don't even know where to start. And I should have created the system from the beginning. Well, that's the ideal situation, but don't fret. There's always time to adapt and change, and our computer, we can do the same thing. Actually, it's easier to start when you do have a lot of files, because then you can already start thinking and clumping files together to create your system. So the first step in creating your system is to look at your files and start putting them into categories, either work or personal. From there, what are the two major themes that arise from both of them? These should be titles of your filing systems. Have a look at my filing systems for inspiration. You can see here that I title a lot of them, all of them are in documents, and they all go into either work or personal, and they're all labeled by major theme that they're in. And I can click on each one of them, and then within them also has subfiles. A lot of people also ask me about how I keep my photos organized, and that's going to be a whole nother YouTube. So my next tip is digital minimalism. Now, I preach removing clutter and minimalism in all facets of my life, but I also think it needs to be done digitally. So how often do we keep files or items on our computer that we actually need and don't need? We think, oh, we don't need to print this, we'll just save it on our computer. But we really need to employ those same methods that we're using when bringing things into our home that we're using to store stuff on our computer. So really, before you, let's save something as a PDF to your computer or save that next email, really think, review it and think, do I really need to keep this? And if so, where am I going to place it? My third and biggest tip is to set weekly digital organizing time. Whether it's 10 minutes or 30 minutes, maybe at the end of your week, but you need to organize your digital life. And a lot of us save files to our desktop. I know we all do this, so it's a great time to go through those and then digitally organize them just like we would a regular filing cabinet. So I also quarterly schedule backups on my computer, which is a great idea as well because we are storing a lot of things digitally. So comment below. I would love to hear your digital organizational tips. So now that you have my three tips to start getting and hopefully staying digitally organized, next week I'm going to be sharing my few key strategies of getting rid of clutter. It's a tough subject, but when clutter is lingering, either digitally or in real life, we'll always be less productive. As mentioned, I'm going to be giving away my number one productivity tool, and you can enter to win a free time cube below, which is one of my, as mentioned, favorite time management tool. So please enter your email below. And if you like this video, please let me know by giving a thumbs up, subscribe, and share it with your friends. Thank you and see you next Tuesday.